control through the travel and gets in the left rear quarter panel and turns the 48. Yeah, right there, the 14's pushing the 48. Gets his turn around. Now, push blade up in the air. Fortunately, came down on his tires. There it starts, right there. That trial, we talked about earlier, that is the worst place. That's where your car has the least amount of grip around this racetrack.
And remember, these race cars are 3,400 pounds flying through the air like toy cars.
Right there, it starts. Seems like it gets calmed down, but another bit of contact. Now the 48's around into the side of the one.
And the one's headed into the outside wall at full speed. Frightening view out the front of that car. As you know, that impact's coming. Anywhere from 30 to 40 G's head on into the fence.
But Boyer in stage one decided to back out of it. And this stage, he decided to go try to get some points.
And look at there on the right side of the street, 18 car. Kyle Busch trying to avoid the wreck. Slides up into Brandon Gaughan. Jimmy, look at the hands on the wheel. Whoa.
He was turning hard right and the car was still going left.
Anytime you get pushed in the left rear quarter panel, the way the aero works on these cars, it just spins the lead car out.
A lot of cars involved. There were 11 laps to go in stage two.
I was trying to miss the 48 as he's coming off the wall and gets a little bit of contact in the right rear tire.
Now, quickly, that car,
the contact, the head on hit into the outside walls. Really scary to watch. This shot.
Number three had come off the 48 just before all of this happened. Steve.
Rick, we've seen a bunch of replays. I happened to be listening to the 48 when the accident happened because of that debris. I wanted to hear if they were overheating. He was very frustrated with Clint Boyer.